And our newest plane, the Cub Sport S2, I believe it is. A very small plane. It's actually nice because you could fly it in a field and stuff, and the battery just kind of goes right there and then Velcros in, which is nice. It has safe flight, and it hooks up to the DXS really nicely, actually. Pairs right with it. No bind plug necessary. And yeah, we'll do a little bit of flying with this baby. We got the UMX Timber up in the air right now. So, let's see, where is the end? There it is. And flying over is. So, yeah, very cool. Let's check it out. Alright, so the battery simply just clips in.
Is this way?
Other way.
Oh.
Yeah, like that, I believe. And just clips right in. And then you Velcro it to the other way. Yeah, there you go. And it sits right in there like that. Yep, perfect.
Okay. And then you just turn this on?
Yeah, hold the bind plug and turn it on.
Is that the bind button?
Yeah. Yep, there you go.
Okay, and then this is the engine switch right here?
That's the engine switch, actually. It actually has a kill for the prop, which is nice. And there you go.
So right now it's not working. Okay. Alright, here we go. Engine is on. Oh, yeah. Yeah, this control is also not as, like, healthy as another.
Yeah, it's kind of good, huh? I kind of like it.
This big plane up there.
So we have the DSX6, and then we've got, this one actually came with the Carbon Cub, and it's just a DXS, but it doesn't have an LCD screen or anything, but I really like that controller.
I like the other one.
It binds really easy, and it just does everything really easy.
Yeah. I like that one though because it has a screen and a timer and everything.
Yeah, it has a timer and everything, but I mean this is pretty cool though. See, this doesn't have an LCD screen. This is if you buy a ready-to-fly plane, they'll actually give you the controller and they'll give you the DSX. And I believe those things, I want to say they're like $75 if you buy them, so it's a pretty good deal. Let me change the camera angle. So,
right, so more,
now we're
like,
zooming way in.
Like it's not as. There's no beep sounds.
No.
It feels more smooth. Okay. The control.
I thought it was pretty easy actually, the control. And it was a Maiden flight today and I just took it right out and flew it. And I haven't even flown an RC plane ever, so it's pretty cool. Damn. Oh, sorry, lost it. It's hard when you're zoomed in like that. Let me go to 3 real quick.
Well, this thing takes off really fast,
actually. I really like this plane. So this thing's like $120, basically, without the remote. And maybe they do make a ready-to-fly version that comes with that remote, which...
I thought the Timber was ready-to-fly, though. Or is it not? Well,
I mean, it's... It basically is ready-to-fly. Will it flip back over? No. Come on, baby! No, it just got a little bit off. It's funny, you can see it's kind of pitched on its wing. Oh, there it goes. That's funny.
Yeah, the Timber doesn't flip over, though.
No, that the Timber really doesn't flip over.
That's my spot.
I'm sorry.
Of course, I'm going to start walking over there at Timber.
Yeah.
This thing definitely doesn't have a lot of power as the Timber does.
Oh, and you said you were right though, when you give it gas and aim it down, it actually does crank right through here in the wind, which was pretty good. Perfect.
What's the, like, the advanced mode control?
It's this. Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, get it up in some altitude and flip that thing off and do a loop or something.
I could try, I mean.
Well, you just flip it right back on after you do the loop, and then it just stables, just like, stables that, like, right out. This would be a good plane to practice that with, that's for sure. The cheapest plane that way, if you do a crash, it's not a big deal. There you go. Sweet. That was a quick one.
Yeah.
It's way up there.
Kind of hard to bring down when you're going against the wind.
That's what I was saying too. I mean, you can angle it down, but it doesn't really lose that much altitude when you're doing it. I mean, look, it just glides right in now. It just makes you think of Trevor and how he could have just floated that Taylor craft right down to the ground and landed it instead of letting it crash and having a parachute on, but whatever, we won't talk about that. Feel bad for that plane though. I wanted that plane.
I wouldn't really want a tail dragger.
Really? Why? Just harder to control?
No, not that. It's just that you could flip it over at any moment when you're landing. Especially.
And this technically isn't its maiden flight, but it's close enough to its maiden flight to call it its maiden flight. Here's another loop. That's a nice thing. You just flip this thing out of safe mode and boom. Pretty far up there now. Just gliding, huh? Look at that. No engine at all. Just. Is it just falling out of the sky? No, it's not. Because planes aren't made to fall out of the sky.
Well, I mean,
so if you're in
airliners
Odessa,
do like
that. Only those are jets. These are not made to do that.
Yeah, Cubs and stuff.
Yeah, Cubs and all these type of planes, no way. Whoa. Pitched out a little bit, but hey, it worked. Yeah, that's a pretty cool plane, man.
This plane does not have the biggest wheels.
No, it's a small plane. It's a small one of the smallest versions you can get. But I mean, the nice thing is you could bring this to a park or pretty much anywhere. I mean, I would probably recommend signing up with the AMA and registering it with the FAA. But yeah, if you do sign up for the AMA, you are insured. So if you did wreck into somebody, you at least would have a little bit of insurance. Nice. Or flip. And
down.
Like I said, this would be a great practice plane to actually
down.
Take it out of safe mode and
go down. Okay, go down.
And mess around with it so that you know you're not losing a whole lot if you crash this. It's $120, and it probably could be repaired anyways. Nice flight. It's probably about good. Huh? It's like 5 minutes. Here's the taxi. Come on, buddy. It just doesn't want to. Huh, you gotta bring it back this way. Give up. The smaller planes are way harder to taxi, so. So what do you think? You like it?
Yeah, definitely.
It's a pretty cool plane, huh?
Yep. This one's cool. It has, like, cutoff.
Yeah. Yeah, I like that. It has the engine cutoff is actually channel 8 or something, I believe, or some one of them.
What?
What channel is that that it's on? It's this one, whatever that one is. I don't know.
I don't
but
know.
It actually cuts off the prop, which is very nice.